Welcome. My name is Justin Sipes. I'm the director with the Center for Community-Based Learning, and this is a tutorial on Osprey Impact. Osprey Impact is a system for you to log hours that you're doing with the community. You're likely accessing this for a course that you're taking currently, but if you're doing other service activities, you can also log those hours into the system. Through this tutorial, I'm going to show you three different aspects of the system. The first is logging into the system. The second is how you add a class to the system. And finally, how you add an impact or hours into the system. To start, logging into the system, there are two ways that you can access it. The first is through My Wings, and then on the left navigation bar, clicking on Student Life, and then clicking on Osprey Impact. This will take you to the Osprey Impact site. The other way, by going to your search bar and typing in unf.givepulse.com. And this will also take you to Osprey Impact. What you're currently seeing is the classic view of the system. Recommend switching to the new view as this system will switch over to this new beta release within the next months. If it is your first time logging into the system, you'll need to click on sign up. You'll be prompted then to use your UNF credentials in order to log into the system and create your account. If this is your second time, you'll click on login, where again, you'll be prompted to use your UNF credentials to access the system. As you can see, the system uses a single sign-on process, and you will be required to use the two-factor authentication. So make sure you have whatever device you need for that close at hand. Once you've accessed the system, you'll be taken back to the main page where you'll see that you're now in the system. Next thing we're going to do is add the class. So here in this middle navigation bar, you'll see various options. We're going to click on classes. And then what you want to do is make sure that you're in the correct term. So currently we're in the fall 2022 term. You'll notice that there's courses that are already in the system for that particular term. You'll click on whatever name of the class you're currently taking associated with the Osprey Impact system. For this tutorial, I'm going to go into the sample class that I've created. Once I click on the sample class, over here in this navigation bar area, there'll be the option to join. As you can see, I've already joined, which is why it says joined. The other thing to confirm is make sure that you're in the right course. Over here under course information will be the name, subject, ID, CRN, and the name of the course. And again, over here on the right where contacts are will be the instructors for the course. Make sure that you're in the right section of the course as there are a couple courses that have similar names. The other recommendation is that once you've added your course is to bookmark the course that will be easier to return to in the future. The bookmarking process will vary depending on your browser. For Google Chrome users, simply clicking the star up here in the top right, and then it'll be easier to access in the future. Once you've added a class, the next thing that we'll be doing is adding an impact. So this is where you input the hours that you've been doing associated with your course. Anytime you're adding an impact, you want to make sure that you're in the class for which you're adding the hours for the particular course. So as we can see, I'm currently in the sample class, which is where I want to add the hours. So I'll select on Add Impact, which will take us to a new screen. And this is where we'll enter our information. Always confirm that you're in the right organization or class when you're going to be adding an impact, which you'll see here. The next part is going to be to select a verifier. All impacts need to be verified by an individual. If you click on the dropdown here, the instructors and the administrators for the course will be options. If it is an external individual who needs to verify the hours you're inputting, you're going to click on the hyperlink here, and that'll open up new information. In the verifier's name, what you're going to do is input the name of the person who can verify the impact, and then you're going to input their email address as well. What will happen is that once you submit this impact, this individual at this email address will receive a notification that an impact has been input into the system, and then they will have the option to verify that impact. The next area, what you're going to do is select the date range associated with the impact. This will vary based on your instructor, so please make sure you understand how often you should be entering impacts into the system. In order to change the date range, simply click on the calendar date, or click on the date, and then the calendar will pop up, and then you can adjust the dates associated with the impact. This next box, what you will do is enter the number of hours you did during that time period. Under this next section and community partner, you're going to name the organization that you did the service with. Many of you, it'll be a school that you're working with, or it might be a nonprofit organization or a different organization. Just put whatever name of that entity here in this next box. In the About Your Experience section, under the review, reflection, and feedback, you should input actual information about what you were doing during that time period. So for this, I'll say that I'm creating a tutorial for students. The other thing that's important to know when you're writing in the review, reflection, and feedback is that whoever you have indicated as the verifier will be able to see the information that you input into this review, reflection, and feedback section. If there are things that you want to include, but you don't want people to know, you would input it into the personal notes section here. This is not a required section to fill out, but if there are items you'd like to include, feel free to do so. With attachments, your instructor might ask you to upload documents. Could be pictures, a Word doc, an Excel sheet. This is the place you would do that if that is a request. Otherwise, you can ignore this section. Finally, if you're a part of other organizations within the Osprey Impact system, you can share the impact with them in this sharing area here. Lastly, if you're going to, in adding your impact, you can choose to make it private or not. If you choose to make it private, the administrators and the verifiers will still be able to see the information that you input into the system. If you say no, that means that the information you input for that impact will be able to be seen publicly at the main site of Osprey Impact. Finally, once you've added all the information here, select Add Impact. And at this point, you'll be taken to a new screen where you'll see that currently the verification is pending. You'll also notice that your reflection information is included here, the dates range that you input, the number of hours that you indicated, who the impact is associated with, who the community partner is that you are doing the work with, and then who the requested verifier is, so the person you indicated that you want to verify this request. Again, once you've clicked the Add Impact button, this individual will automatically receive an email from the system asking them to verify the hours. Once the verification has been determined, this indicator up here will change within the impact to green, to letting you know that it has been verified. If this is red, what that means is the individual has denied the verification, and then a justification will explain why it has been denied. If for any point you want to come back to an impact in the future to check on it, up here in the top right, you'll have the ability to click on My Activity, and you'll be able to click Impacts. This will take you to all the impacts that you've input into the system, where you then will be able to access them again. This is also a quick way to get to your classes. So once you've added a class, you can simply come to the My Activity navigational area here, click on Classes, and you'll see all classes that you're assigned to. That is the tutorial for accessing Osprey Impact. Again, we've covered how you log into the system, either through MyWings or through typing into the URL or typing the URL into your navigation bar, how to add a class, and then how to add impacts into the system. If ever at any point in time you're unsure or you're having problems or questions, you can click over here where the contacts is from the main page, and it'll send me a message to let me know the issues you are having, or you can email ospreyimpact@unf.edu. Thank you for viewing this tutorial. And again, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out.